Joining us now is Manila Mayor Francisco Isko Moreno. He's among those being considered by this new coalition to be part of their ticket in 2022. Well, good morning, Mayor Moreno, and thank you for joining us again on the program.
Hi, Christian. Good morning sa iyo at sa iyong mga staff dyan sa ANC at inyong manonood. Magandang umaga.
Magandang umaga po, Mayor. Before we talk about your city's response to this new surge in COVID-19 cases, I'd like to ask about the fact that you are being considered by this new coalition Isambayan to be part of their ticket, either to run for president or vice president. Are you open to this or have you actually agreed?
Well, una, no, Christian, thank you sa kanila. I'm honored and thankful to the organizing committee for giving me such honor to be included in those list that they choose, na pwede nilang makonsider. But it's quite unfair to our viewers, especially Manilans, to talk about politics for the remainder of your minutes, no, in this show. Because we continue to really address now the surge of the numbers of infection in the city. I'm just thankful, and I don't want to entertain anymore any politics for now. I think there will be time for everything.
Okay.
Pasensya ka na. Pasensya ka na.
No problem. But I need to ask you about that because your name was floated yesterday. Anyway, let's talk about this this bigger issue at hand.
Yes.
So there's says the numbers. What are the numbers that you are seeing currently as far as the surge is concerned, and how? What are the adjustments being made by the Manila City government in terms of dealing with the surge in cases?
For the past 2 weeks, no, Christian, talagang may parang unnecessary growth, no, at some point. There must be neglect along the way, and that is a fact. Whoever it is, we don't want to point fingers anymore, but there is a growing numbers of infection among cities in Metro Manila and all other parts of the country. And your city government is going back to a 24/7 operation to monitor if rules are being implemented properly by the enforcement agencies, and barangays are doing their thing or their responsibility to contain infection and other simple medical protocol or health rules, no? At ang city naman ngayon ay talagang tuloy-tuloy yung aming paghahanap at pagla-lockdown, or what you call the granular lockdown, no? So that
ilan po yung naka-lockdown ngayon ng mga communities, and how many more communities considered
last week? Last week, Christian, we locked down 3 barangays, no? 2 barangays and 2 buildings. So yung 2 building na sa isang barangay. At nakaraos naman na because of that, Christian, nabigyan, paved the way sa ating mga tracer efficiently and tested a lot of people within the barangay, those community. And sa lalong madaling panahon, natagpuan pa natin yung iba pang infected that na wala silang ka-idea na infected na sila. About 25 of them, no, na nakuha ulit natin. Na nakaraos na yun, nabigyan din natin sila ng food boxes as we have a plan to really mitigate the socioeconomic impact of this COVID-19, no, sa buhay ng tao. Napaaga lang yung para sa kanila ngayong Marso. Then, about a few days ago, Christian, meron naman tayo ni-lockdown ulit. No? 6 na barangay naman. This will affect about 7,900 families. Ang total noong populasyon ng barangay na yan. No? At ongoing yan ngayon as we speak. Naka-lockdown sila. At nabigyan na rin sila ng food boxes, and we continue to trace and test a lot of people para naman sa ganun.
Ilan yung Mayor, ilan yung average na natetrace nyo for every person that tests positive? And are you hiring more contact tracers? Because this is a big problem by the national government.
Sa awa ng Diyos, ano, fully equipped and logistically speaking, so far, ang City of Manila, because we've been preparing for this kind of situation, na sakaling nga dumating yung worst scenario. So we still have enough group of people as tracers. At ang bawat isang tao ay umaabot kami hanggang 11 up to 15 individuals per infected person within the community. No? Nahahanap naman yan. At nakakaraos naman, Christian. Tapos yung mga ordinansa natin ay patuloy na pinatutupad. Mas mahigpit lamang ngayon, talagang sobrang higpit. Kasi, Christian, alam mo naman, we really need to address two things, no, nowadays. While it is true that there is a health issue, but there is also an economic repercussion of every policy that we're going to introduce. And the economy is hurting, and we know that already. I think any John Doe's and Mary's nowadays understand that. So, binabalansin na natin.